Peace! Who comes here?
Oh, your lordship is right. Welcome back to Denmark.
I humbly thank you, sir. Dost know this waterfly?
I don't know, my good lord.
I will receive it, sir, with all diligent spirit. Put your bonnet to his right use. It is for the head.
I thank you, your lordship, but it's very hot.
No, believe me, it's very cold. The wind is northern.
It is indifferent. Cold, my lord, indeed.
But yet, methinks it is very sultry and hot for my complexion.
Exceedingly, my lord, it is very sultry. As 'twere, I cannot tell. My lord, majesty has bade you to signify that you has laid a great wager upon your head. Sir, this is the matter.
I beseech you.
Nay, my good lord, for my ease and good faith. Sir, here is newly come to court Laertes, believe me. An absolute gentleman full of the most excellent differences of very soft society, and great showing indeed, speaks sellingly of him. He is the card or calendar of gentry, for you shall find him in the continent of what part a gentleman will see.
Sir, his definement suffers no perdition in you, though I know to divide him inventorially would disease the arithmetic of memory. And yet, but y'all neither, in respect of his quick sale, but in the verity of extolment, I take him to be a soul of great article, and his infusion of such dearth and rareness, to make tradition of him, his semblable in his mirror, and who else would trace him, his umbrage, nothing more.
Your lordship speaks most infallibly.
Is the concern of Caesar? Why do we wrap the gentleman in our more raw breath?
Is it not possible to understand in another tongue? You will to it, sir, really.
What imports the nomination of this gentleman?
Of Laertes?
His purse is empty already. All his golden words are spent.
Of him, sir.
I know you're not ignorant.
I would you did, sir. Yet, in faith, if you did, it would not much approve me. Well, sir?
You are not ignorant of what excellence Laertes is.
I dare not confess that, lest I should compare with him in excellence, but to know a man well were to know himself.
I mean, sir, for his weapon, but in the imputation laid on him by them in this mead, he's unfellowed.
What's his weapon?
Rapier and dagger.
Well, that's two of his weapons, but well.
The king, sir, hath wagered him 6 Barbary horses, against which he is imponed, as I take it, 6 French rapiers and poniards with their assigns as girdle hangers, and so, 3 of the carriages in faith are very dear to fancy, very responsive to the hills, most delicate carriages and of very liberal conceit.
I knew you must be edified by the margent, ere you had done.
The carriages, sir, are the hangers.
Oh. The phrase would be more germane to the matter. If we could carry cannon by our sides, I would it might be hangers till then. But on 6 Barbary horses against 6 French swords, there are signs, and 3 liberal conceited carriages. That's the French bet against the Danish. Why is this imponed, as you call it?
The king, sir, hath laid, sir, that in a dozen passes between yourself and him, he shall not exceed you 3 hits. He hath laid on 12 for 9, and it would come to immediate trial if your lordship would vouchsafe the answer.
How if I answer no?
I mean, my lord, the opposition of your person in trial.
Sir, I will walk here in the hall, if it pleases his majesty. 'Tis the breathing time of day with me. Let the foils be brought, the gentleman willing, and the king hold his purpose. I will win for him, and I can. If not, I will gain nothing but my shame and the odd hits.
Shall I deliver you so?
To this effect, sir, after what flourish your nature will.
I commend my duty to your lordship.
Yours. He does well to commend it himself. There are no tongues else for his turn.
This lapwing runs away with the shell on his head.
He did comply with his dog before he sucked it. Thus has he, and many more of the same bevy that I know, the dressy age dotes on. Only got the tune of the time and outward habit of encounter. A kind of yesy collection which carries them through and through the most fond and winnowed opinions. And do but blow them to their trial, the bubbles are out.
My lord, his majesty commended him to you by young Alseric, who brings him back to him that you attend him in the hall. He sends to know if you hold pleasure to hold play with Laertes, or that you will take longer time.
I am constant to my purpose. They follow the king's pleasure. If his fitness speaks, mine is ready. Now or whensoever, provided I be able
The king and queen are coming down now.
In happy time.
The queen desires you to use some gentle entertainment to Laertes before you play.
She well instructs me.
You will lose, my lord.
Your mother.
Yeah.
You will lose, my lord. You will
lose.
I do not think so. Since you went to France, I have been in continual practice. I shall win at the odds. But thou wouldst not think how ill all's here about my heart, but it is no matter.
Nay, good, my lord.
It is but foolery. But it is such a kind of gain-giving as would perhaps trouble a woman.
If your mind dislike anything, obey it. I will forestall the repair hither and say you are not fit.
Not a whit. We defy augury. There's a special providence in the fall of a sparrow. If it be now, it is not to come. If it be not to come, it will be now. If it be not now, yet it will come. The readiness is off, since no man has aught of what he leaves. What is to leave betimes?
Come, Hamlet, take this hand from me.
Give me your pardon, sir. I've done you wrong, but pardon as you were a gentleman. This presence knows, and you must needs have heard, how I am punished with sore distraction. What I have done that might your nature honor an exception roughly awake, here I proclaim was madness. Was Hamlet wrong, Laertes? Never Hamlet. If Hamlet from himself be taken away, and when he's not himself does wrong Laertes, then Hamlet does it not. Hamlet denies it. Who does it then? His madness, if be so, Hamlet is of the faction that is wrong. His madness is poor Hamlet's enemy.
Sir, in this audience, let my disclaiming from a purposed evil free me so far in your most generous thoughts that I have shot mine arrow over the house and hurt my brother.
I am satisfied in nature. Whose motive in this case should stir me most? To my revenge, but in my terms of honor, I stand aloof and will no reconcilement. Till by some elder masters of known honor, I have a voice and precedent of peace to keep my name ungored. But till that time, I do receive your offer, love like love, and will not wrong it.
I embrace it freely, and will this brother's wager frankly play? Give us the foils, come on.
Come one for me.
I'll be your foil, Laertes. In mine ignorance, your skill shall, like a star in the darkest night, stick fiery off indeed.
You mock me, sir.
No, by this hand.
Give them the foils, young Osric. Cousin Hamlet, you know the wager.
Very well, my lord. Your grace hath laid the odds over the weaker side.
I do not fear it. I have seen you both. But since he is better, we have therefore odd.
This is too heavy. Let me see another.
This likes me well, these foils all alike.
Aye, my good lord.
Set me the stoups of wine upon that table. If Hamlet give the first or second hit, or quit in answer of the third exchange, let all the battlements of the ordnance fire. The king shall drink to Hamlet's better breath, and in the cup, a union, shall he throw richer than which four successive kings in Desmond's crown have worn. Give me the cups. And let the kettle to the trumpet speak, the trumpet to the cannoneer without, the cannons to the heavens to the earth. Now, the king drinks to Hamlet. Come, begin. And you, the judges, bear a weary eye.
Come on, sir.
Come, my lord.
Round one, fight!
No!
Judgment?
Oh, a hit. A very palpable hit. Well, again.
Stay. Give me drink, Hamlet.
Well, again.
Stay. Give me drink. Hamlet, this pearl is thine. Here's to thy help. Give him the cup.
I'll play this bout first. Set it by a while. Come.
Another hit. I do concede.
Our son shall win.
He's faint and scant of breath. Here, have my napkin. And rub thy brows. The green carouses to thy fortune, Hamlet.
Valley good, madam.
Get you, do not drink!
Oh, but I will, my lord. I pray you pardon me.
It's the poison cup. It's too late.
I dare not drink yet, madam. By and by.
Come, let me wipe thy face then.
My lord, I will hit him now.
I do not think.
It is almost against my conscience.
Come for the third, Laertes, you bedally. I pray you, pass with your best violence. I am afeard that you make a wanton.
Say you so, come on.
Nothing, neither way.
Have at you now. They bleed on both sides. How is it, my lord?
How is it, Laertes?
What you say? That you only meant well, cause you did. What you say? That it's all for the best, cause it is.
How does the queen?
She sounds to see them bleed.
No, the drink. Oh, my dear Hamlet, the drink, I am poisoned.
Why is a wood's cock to my own springe? Osric, I am justly killed with mine own treachery.
Oh, villainy! Ho, let the door be locked. Treachery, seek it out.
It is here, Hamlet. Thou art slain. No medicine in the world can do thee good. In thee there is not half an hour of life. The treacherous instrument in thy hand, unbated and venomed, the foul practice hath turned itself to me. Lo, here I lie, never to rise again. Thy mother is poisoned. I can no more. The king's to blame.
The point. And venom too. Then venom to thy work.
Oh! That you only meant well, cause you did. What you say? That it's all for the best, of course it is.
Oh, yet defend me, friends. I am but hurt.
He is justly served. It is a poison, tempered by himself. Exchange forgiveness with me, noble Hamlet. Mine and my father's death come not upon thee, nor thine on me.
Bruh.
I've died so many times.
Here, thou incestuous, murderous, damned dame, drink of this poison. Is thy union here? Follow my mother.
Bruh.
Heaven, make thee free of it. I follow thee. I am dead, Horatio. Wretched queen, adieu. You that look pale and tremble at this chance, that are but mutes or audience to this act. Had I but time, as this fellow sergeant, Death, is stripped to his arrest. Oh, I can tell you, let it be, Horatio. I am dead. Thou livest, report me and my cause aright to the unsatisfied.
Never believe it. I am more an antique Roman than a Dane. Here's yet some liquor left.
As thou'rt a man, give me the cup, let go. By heaven, I'll have it. Oh, good Horatio, what a wounded name. Things standing this unknown, shall live behind me. If thou didst ever hold me in thy heart, absent thee from felicity a while, and in this harsh world draw thy breath in pain to tell my story. What warlike noise is this? I die, Horatio. The potent poison quite o'ercrowds my spirit. I cannot live to hear the news from England, but I do prophesy the election lights on Fortinbras. He has my dying voice, so tell him with the occurrence more and less which have solicited. The rest is silent.
What you say? That you only meant well, cause you did.
Young Fortinbras, with conquests come from Poland, to the ambassadors of England gives this warlike folly.
Now cracks a noble heart. Good night, sweet prince, and flights of angels, sing thee to thy rest. Why does the drum come hither?
Where is this sight?
It's aught of woe or wonder. Cease your search.
This quarry cries of havoc, O proud death. What feast is toward in thine eternal cell, that thou so many princes at a shot so bloodily hast struck?
The sight is dismal, and our affairs from England come too late. The ears are senseless that should give us hearing, to tell him his commandment is fulfilled, that Rosencrantz and Guildenstern are dead. Where should we have our thanks?
Not from his mouth had the ability of life to thank you. He never gave commandment for their death. A censor jump upon this bloody question. You from the Polack Wars, and you from England, are here arrived. Give order that these bodies high on stage be placed to the view. And let me speak to the yet unknowing world how these things came about. So shall you hear of carnal, bloody, in unnatural acts, of accidental judgments, casual slaughters, of deaths put on by cunning and forced cause. And in this upshot, purposes mistook, fall on the inventor's heads. All this can I truly deliver.
Let us haste to hear it, and call the noblest to the audience. For me, with sorrow I embrace my fortune, I have some rights of memory in this kingdom, which now, to claim my vintage, doth invite me.
Of that I shall also have cause to speak. And from his mouth, whose voice will draw on more. But let this same presently performed, even while men's minds are wild, lest more mischance on plots and errors happen.
Let four captains bear Hamlet, like a soldier, to the stage, for he was likely had been put on, to have proved most royally, and for his passage, the soldier's music and the rites of war speak loudly for him. Take up the bodies. Such a sight as this becomes a field, but here shows such a miss. Go, bid the soldiers shoot.
All right, perfect. Yay!